In this video, I wanted to take a quick look at the contacts and account modules of FM Starting Point. Now, arguably, the contacts module is one of the most popular modules in FM Starting Point. Now, some businesses may call this their people or customers modules, but effectively, this is where all the people are going to go in the database. Accounts are actually designed to be organizations. So these are not people per se. This could be a government agency or a company or maybe even a regional unit of a business. So as you're looking at FM Starting Point, you're going to need to decide if you want to actually use the accounts module. Some businesses are organized in such a way they really don't track accounts separately from contacts. A contact is an account. If you have a business or organization, and say for example you sell widgets to Walmart, and maybe you also sell widgets to another organization, maybe like Costco, you might have different departments within Walmart or Costco, and you actually need to track all the contacts within that organization, then it would make sense that you would keep the accounts, where this might be Walmart at a certain location or Costco at a certain location, and these might be the critical contacts at that location. So in this situation, you're going to want to keep the accounts module functioning and working with the contacts module. Now, we've already done all the hard work to make these two modules relationally work together. As you're inputting a new contact in the contacts module, you actually have the ability to search and attach an account to this contact. It's pretty simple. So I'm going to select new record right here. I'm going to put in my own name. And let's say I want to attach myself to a company that I know is called Global, but because FileMaker is really smart, I can use a wildcard search. So I'm going to click this button right here. I'm going to say OK. And I'm just going to put the letter G right here and press the return key. Now this would show me all the companies that have the first letter of G in their name somewhere. Now we just have a sample database here. It's pretty small. I have Global Enterprises right here. I can select this right here. And it attaches my contact record here to Global Enterprises. Now if I want to jump over to see the Global Enterprises account, I just click right here. Now it jumps to the accounts module and shows me Global Enterprises. I can click right here and see the contacts for this account. And before I only had two, but now I see myself. So this is the relational part of a relational database. The contacts and accounts modules actually interact with each other. There's actually what they call an accounts table of information and a contacts table of information, and they are relationally connected together. Now, besides relationally connecting the contacts and accounts together, we've also hooked up any related estimates or quotes that we have, any related invoices that we have, or jobs or projects. Now, in this case, we don't have a lot of really crazy sample data here, but if I flip over here to the next record back in my database by using the navigational control right here, I can see that in American Industries sample record right here, I do have a related project right here. If I click on invoices, I can see that I have a number of sample invoices right here as well. Now notice right here, I have dollar amounts right here, but the total and grand total are not up to date. This is an important structural design in FM Starting Point to keep the performance of the database running in top condition, especially if you have a number of users sharing the database over a wide area network like the intranet. To update this information right here, simply press Update Totals right here. Now, why doesn't it update that automatically? Because that took a little bit of performance from the computer. Now, if you're on an iPad and on a 3G network that's maybe a little shaky somewhere, pressing this button right here might cause the system to calculate for 30-45 seconds. And if you really don't need to know this information, why have the system calculate this for you automatically? It makes no sense to do that. Every time you flip through here, you don't need the system automatically churning and calculating those numbers for you. So we only have the system update this information if you specifically request that it be updated. Just keep in mind, if you're on a slower computer, on a slower network connection, you might get a progress bar or another dialog telling you it's going to be just a second while this information is being updated. So that covers a basic overview of the contacts and accounts modules. Now keep in mind you have a couple other nifty features in the contacts module. You also have the ability to manage email sending in the contacts module. I can click email menu right here, and we have the ability to store pre-canned emails right here. I can click the button right here, and it will load a pre-canned email into our system, and it will send that email out to the individual user, or we can send it out to the found group of records in our found set. Of course, we can create our own custom sets of emails that are specific to my company. In our sample database, we don't have that many custom emails. You're going to need to set up your own emails that are specific for your own organization or your own business. Right here, I have a list view, so I can see a list of all the contacts in my contacts module. And of course, we can see the contact details here, or I can click on one of the specific buttons next to a specific individual and drill down and see the information for that person. That pretty much wraps up a brief overview of the accounts and contacts modules in FM Starting Point.